Hi, and welcome to eSpares. My name's Matt. In this video, I'll be replacing the display PCB on an LG washing machine. PCB stands for printed circuit board, and this part can be found inside the control panel at the front of the machine. This part allows you to electronically select your washers, programs, and functions. You'll know when it's failed because you'll no longer be able to select these functions. The digital display at the front will no longer be showing any digits, and the buttons won't be lighting up. Thankfully, you can replace this part easily instead of replacing the machine, as long as you know the steps to take. Let's take a look. For this fix, you'll need a flathead screwdriver and a Phillips screwdriver. You'll also need a new display PCB, which you can find a link for in the description below. And remember, safety first. Always make sure your appliance is switched off and unplugged from the mains before carrying out any work. First thing to do on the machine is to remove the top by undoing the two Phillips screws that hold it in place. Once the screws are removed, simply push back, lift up, and move out the way. Next, remove the soap drawer from its housing by pushing down the small siphon cover. There may be a little hand with an extended finger sign indicating where you can push to slide the drawer free. Now it's time to remove the control panel. To do this, simply undo the two Phillips head screws at the front here. Then, using your flathead screwdriver, release the control panel's clips. This will let you ease the panel off the machine. When doing this, take care not to crack or damage the panel with your screwdriver. Once unscrewed and unclipped, the control panel will still be connected by its electrical connections. Now, these connections are color-coded, but we recommend taking a photo of them before disconnecting them, just to be on the safe side. This is because these connections will need reconnecting to the control panel in the same places later. I'm actually going to take a couple of photos as there's 9 electrical connections to this circuit board here. Next, you'll need to remove the PCB housing from inside the control panel. Using your Phillips screwdriver, unscrew the housing from inside the panel and remove it. Now you need to remove the control knob so you can fit it onto your new display PCB. Now it's time to remove the old display PCB from the housing. Carefully unclip from the PCB housing, taking care not to break the clips as you do this. So if you simply push them in, and then you can lever the PCB out from one side. So gently push these clips back, being careful not to break it, and then that should release the PCB. Take your time with this. You don't want to damage the housing. To make sure you get the correct display PCB for your washing machine, you're going to need your appliance's model number. This will ensure you're getting the exact part for your machine. If you're unsure about where to find the model number on your appliance, check out our video here. You can now fit your new display PCB. To do so, slot it into the housing on one side. You'll know which one to choose first because these clips are not movable. And then push it down into the housing. And those clips should hold it in place. You can gently push those clips back in to hold it firmly in position. You can then replace the control knob back into the display PCB. You can then fit your new display PCB and housing into the control panel before refitting the screws. Now we can refit the electrical connections to the PCB using the photos that we took earlier as a reference. To refit the control panel to the washing machine, these tabs here need to sit in the holes in the frame here. You can then push the top of the control panel into place. With the control panel clipped in place, you can now refit the two screws that were behind the soap dispenser drawer. Refit the soap dispenser drawer, pushing down on the siphon in the middle to make sure it goes in perfectly. You can then refit the top and refit the two Phillips screws at the back. So there we have it, one new display PCB fitted to this LG washing machine. Now that your machine is up and running once again, why not make sure that you're using it properly too? Check out our video down here on washing machine settings to make sure that you're getting the most out of your machine and using it effectively and efficiently. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for all things eSpares, repair guides, handy appliance, maintenance advice, and much, much more. Thanks for watching.